Hey everybody, Scott Spreitzer here, DocSports.com. My update for Monday, April 8, 2019, college basketball championship goes tonight. We'll talk a little bit more about that in just a bit, along with the free pick. But first, before I get to all of that, a quick note. If you've yet to become a member at DocSports.com, real cool way to give it a trial run. You click on the link below the video and you get set up for a free $60 account. You can use that on any of my daily packages over at DocSports.com or anybody else for that matter on the site. Again, it all starts by clicking on the link below the video and grab a free $60 account, and not a bad day to do it. I've got a 7-star main event going in tonight's college basketball championship. It is the side, and we found a couple of things that we think one side is going to benefit from in this game. We like it quite a bit, and again, that's over at DocSports.com on Monday morning. It'll be up after 11:30 a.m. Eastern, 8:30 a.m. Pacific, and again, we'll have a little bit more discussion on college basketball's championship game in just a minute. What happened yesterday? A nice 4-0 sweep for us. 5-0 if you include the free pick here, but 4-0 with our premium picks as we went 2-0 in the NBA. Had a small play on the San Antonio Spurs. They won by 22. And thanks for those who jumped on board yesterday as we had that 7-unit play in the NBA on the Houston Rockets. Listen, it was an 18.5-point favorite. We knew it was a fantastic spot. We knew they'd be ready to play, and they absolutely were as Houston jumped out to a 10-point first quarter lead. Never look back, 149-113, 36-point win. So it's nice when you go 2-0, and the closest margin of victory is a 22-point win. So overall, a nice 2-0 day. We go to 19-5, 79% the last 24 in the NBA. We're now up about $4,500 for those wagering just $100 per unit as we inch a little bit closer to the postseason. Don't miss those postseason packages. We've always had strong success in the 25 years that I've been betting and in the sports betting business. And again, we're on a 19-5 run through Sunday. No NBA on Monday. We might get back into action on Tuesday. I'll let you know on Tuesday's video. Got to check out some of those games where a team or two has a reason to play. And some teams close the season, even without a reason to play, close it well, while other teams don't. So we'll let you know on Tuesday morning if we'll have anything for Tuesday night's games. As far as everything else is concerned, Major League Baseball, we cashed the premium pick easily with the Dodgers. They jumped out to a 6-0 lead over the Colorado Rockies and closed with a 12-6 win. And that team's just knocking the cover off the baseball right now. And that with the opinion here yesterday on the Mariners made for a nice 2-0 baseball day. Really like it as these pitchers get a couple of starts under their belt. And this is really when we kick it into gear in Major League Baseball. We've got two plays on Monday's card at DocSports.com. And again, just like the college basketball play, available Monday morning, 11:30 a.m. Eastern, 8:30 a.m. Pacific time. The two baseball plays, one side, one total for Monday night. We like them both quite a bit. And again, as far as college basketball is concerned, oh, wait, let me tell you first quickly about the NHL. On Wednesday's video, I'll have at least one or two series plays for you from the NHL, and then we'll tell you what we're going to do with games one on Wednesday and on Thursday in the NHL. But a couple of series plays for you right here on these videos in the NHL on Wednesday's video. So be sure to check back for that also. All right, college basketball, quick update. Virginia, again, laying 1, 1.5. Basically, half the joints have one. Half the joints have 1.5. That total right around 118. We've seen it go up just a tad, a little bit since that opening movement. Moved it down to as low as 117.5, as we talked about last night. Early action still on Texas Tech. Not as heavily as it was on our video yesterday on Sunday morning, but still the majority of the amount of tickets are on the Texas Tech Red Raiders in this one. But again, Virginia's gotten a little bit more action. I saw money lines of up to as high as 127, 130 on the Virginia Cavaliers just before cutting this video, just past midnight Pacific time on Monday morning. So anyway, that's kind of the update with the betting. Again, a little bit more than, well, not just a little bit, but upwards of, you know, 55 to 62% from the books that I'm looking at that have that kind of ticket count on Texas Tech in this one over Virginia. Now listen, baseball free pick in a minute. Just got a bunch of notes that I wanted to talk about and show you all kind of what we do in Major League Baseball each and every day for the next day's games. And I'm going to kind of talk a little bit about this and tell you what our thoughts are on the next day's baseball games. We kind of did this last year when I first got over to DocSports.com and, you know, basically did it all summer long, telling you where the lines may move on Monday morning, and also give you some insights to kind of what I look at in Major League Baseball. And And it's only going to be the games where I think maybe one team has an advantage. Now, it doesn't mean I'm always going to be on these teams as far as bets or premium picks, but it'll tell you certainly the teams that I will not bet on in the following games. And let's start, first of all, the Pittsburgh Cubs game. Boy, it feels like a spot where the Cubs land in the win column after they did so in Milwaukee and got a win a couple of days ago. And then in this particular game, I think, boy, they come home and they look like they might be in a good spot, but I'm not going to mess with that pitching matchup. And just, you know, looking at some of my notes, I don't like going against teams that have won four straight, which is Pittsburgh. Cubs lose yesterday after winning on Saturday, but a -9 run differential, and we're just going to pass that game altogether. As far as Washington and Philly, you've got Sanchez taking on Velasquez. Vince Velasquez going for the Phils in that one. This line was about 130-ish, Phillies being the favorite, and it has gone up or will go up throughout the night and into Monday morning. Not going to be involved in this game, but I will tell you this much, that you got the better bullpen, obviously, with the Phillies at this point. That Washington bullpen has an ERA of over 10 so far on the season, and right now the Phillies have a +20 run differential, pretty serious numbers for the Phils in that one. The Dodgers are at the Cardinals, and it'll be Ryu against Mikolas. And I got to tell you that, you know, so far this season, a couple of starts, I've not been all that, you know, I guess you could say, thrilled with Miles Mikolas' starts, and he looks to be struggling a little bit. They have the slightly better bullpen right now than the Dodgers as far as the numbers are concerned thus far, but they just don't put men on base like the Dodgers. The Dodgers are now the number one team in batting average and OBP as we speak, and they're averaging almost 8.5 runs per game after last night's 12-6 win. +36 run differential right now for the Dodgers heading into Monday's slate. We're going to talk a little bit more about them in just a bit. The Braves, well, here they are laying about a dollar, getting about $1.25 when it opened, $1.25 dog on the road to Colorado with Tehran and Freeland on the mound. That number is going to come down. It already has started to come down. The Colorado Rockies have a little bit better bullpen heading into this game than do the Braves thus far, but the Braves, much better hitting baseball team right now. They're averaging about 5 runs per game. The Padres and the Giants, boy, you would think that would be a nice spot for an under, the total 7. And again, we have not jumped in on this one. We may before the night is over. But you know, the one thing that I look at this game, and I just think, you know, as far as an under is concerned, is when I look at the pitching report, you never know once in a while when Lauer might have a bad outing. But the bottom line is, in this game, you know, both teams have good bullpens. The Giants are playing well out of the pen, 238, 240 ERA from their relievers. Neither team tearing it up on offense. Both teams averaging about 2.5 to 3.5 runs per game right now. But again, that total 7, I'm not going to be shocked if it comes down a little bit more. And by the way, this is not the total, our premium pick, our premium total for Monday, in case you were wondering. Tampa Bay at the White Sox, almost jumped in on this one. Tampa Bay opened about $1.40 favorite. That one's going up. That'll be Snell and Rodon. A couple of lefties on the mound. And boy, Tampa's bullpen tearing it up right now. 220 ERA, second best in Major League Baseball. The White Sox are averaging almost 2 runs per game more than is Tampa Bay, but the pitching hasn't been there. And Tampa Bay's got a +15 run differential. Last year on the road in day games against lefties, Tampa actually averaged over 5 runs per game. Probably a good play here, but again, when you're looking at a buck, it's going to be $1.50 by Monday morning. We just don't want to lay that big of a price right now on the road. The Oakland A's, they opened about $1.35 favorite on the road to Baltimore, and that number has come down. As far as the Orioles are concerned, they look like they're getting back to the way we thought they would be before the season began after getting thumped in a couple of games against the New York Yankees. But it'll be Cashner on the field today, or on the bump, I should say, for the O's. Don't like what he's doing. As far as Oakland's concerned, much better bullpen right now than Baltimore. Baltimore's bullpen has an ERA of almost 8. They're third from the bottom of all of Major League Baseball as far as hefty ERAs are concerned. Oakland, again, about $1.35 favorite. However, that number has come down a little bit. They'll send Estrada to the bump in that one. A couple of other games that we wanted to note. The Yankees and Tanaka against Houston and Verlander. Right now, that game has the Yankees. Well, they're basically averaging 5.5 runs per game going into this one. And they've got a +18 run differential, but you're going up against Verlander. So, yeah, I wanted to take the Yankees here, but I just can't do it and go against Verlander in this one. Seattle-Kansas City is an interesting matchup because you've got Homer Bailey, who's been garbage for a couple of seasons now. I mean, unmitigated disaster as a starting pitcher in Cincinnati the last couple of years. We'll see if a change of scenery does him well now in Kansas City, but he's going up against Seattle. I mean, I did not see this coming, guys. You just got to admit it sometimes. Seattle could still flounder later on this season. But the bottom line is, it's a team averaging almost 8 runs per game. What are they, 9-2 now? Run differential second only to the Dodgers at plus 29. Hitting the cover off the ball, top 5 in team batting average, top 6 or 7 now in OBP, and a much better bullpen. About a 4.5 ERA for Seattle. Kansas City's bullpen is over 8 so far on the season. As I mentioned, Homer Bailey, just a horrible mess the last couple of years. And I know King Felix Hernandez, his velocity had dropped a little bit last year. His numbers and all the categories he used to dominate had gone up. But he started the season talking a little nasty. He had a little chip on his shoulder from not being named the opening day starter for Seattle. And he pitched pretty well first time out. And against this lineup that's not exactly hitting the cover off the ball in the lower third in baseball and batting average and OBP, you can probably get it done here once they get to the bullpen against Seattle with the much better bullpen. They opened 125. It's dropping a little bit. That's a little bit down from where it opened. And finally, the last game I wanted to mention, the Brewers at the Angels with Chacin against Cahill. Chacin never really helped the Angels out when he was a starting pitcher in Anaheim, but the Brewers opened about $1.10 favorite. That's dropping down a little bit. Angels have the best bullpen in baseball ERA-wise right now, about a 1.5 ERA. The problem is Milwaukee's scoring runs. The Angels are not until the last couple of days. And really, on Saturday, he had 4 runs coming off of one swing of the bat of Mike Trout. But he is on fire right now. But again, not sure I can trust the Angels here in this spot. Lean towards Milwaukee in that one. But again, these aren't all going to be premium picks. We have one total we didn't talk about. We have one side for Monday, both premium picks. But when we have time, I just want to give you a rundown of kind of what we're looking at every single day as we go into baseball season. And yeah, we're up late at night. I'm a night owl, and we get ahead of some of these line moves when we stay up late at night, as we do each and every day throughout the course of the year, handicapping games. All right, let's get to the free pick for Monday. It is the Dodgers at the Cardinals. Just kind of talk about this one a little bit. We like Ryu. He's off to a great start through his first couple of outings this season. We expected nothing less from the lefty, watching him toe the rubber the last couple of years. Not only are his numbers strong, but as I mentioned just a little bit ago, his team's on fire at the plate, averaging over 8 runs per game, already have that plus 36 run differential. I haven't been impressed, as I mentioned, with Miles Mikolas through the first 2 outings of his season. I know he had great numbers last year, but I'm not so sure he's got the staying power this year. And listen, you've got baseball's number 1 ranked offense in batting average and OBP for the Dodgers. That's not exactly the recipe for Mikolas to turn things around against and all of a sudden catch fire. And listen, I had the Dodgers as our premium pick yesterday over at DocSports.com. They're not a premium pick today, but they are the opinion here, the free pick for Monday's card as we look to win again after cashing yesterday with the Mariners. So we'll back the Dodgers, our free pick on Monday. And again, that's Ryu over the Cardinals and Miles Mikolas. And yeah, we know the Dodgers are traveling off Sunday night, but just don't care about that here. They're going to win or they're going to lose because of the play on the field, not because of where they traveled from on Sunday night. So the Dodgers are the free pick. And again, don't forget, 7-star play in college basketball's championship game, the side between Tech and Virginia, available on Monday morning along with 2 baseball plays, 2 premium picks, a total, and a side for Monday. That's going to do it for us on this report. We'll be right back here Tuesday, 4 a.m. Eastern, 1 a.m. Pacific. And don't forget, if you like that these videos, be sure to click on that thumbs up button. Be sure to subscribe. We appreciate those who have done so thus far. Scott Spreitzer, DocSports.com. Put Monday in the win column. Talk to you Tuesday morning.